pretty much, there's always something I'm looking for, and there's always something I find, whether it was what I was looking for in the next moment or minute or song. It's always there with Miranda. Somewhere in there, there's always another moment where I'm taken to a different place. What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel Rockin' the Country. I'm Don. I'm doing one that I hope doesn't get blocked. Miranda Lambert's song, Vice. I may know this one, but I think it's newer. And I can't say I know it. I know Miranda's arguably she's definitely one of my favorite artists of all time in any genre. But the newer stuff I'm not as familiar with. I've been busy with so many other things. But Betty Stafford said that this really shows Miranda's talent, which it must be an amazing song because every song I've ever heard of her shows her ridiculous talent. So here we go. I don't know if it's a review or a reaction. I'll find out in a minute.
Sting of the needle dropping on a vinyl. Neon singer with a jukebox title full of heartbreak. 33, 45, 78.
Vinyl.
When it hurts this good, you gotta play it twice. Another vice. All dressed up in a pretty black label. Sweet salvation on a dining room table waiting on me. Where the numb meets the lonely. It's gone before it ever melts the ice. Another vice. Another bed I shouldn't crawl out of. At 7 a.m. with shoes in my hand. Said I wouldn't do it, but I did it again. And I know I'll be back tomorrow night.
I've heard this. Never listened to it. Betty, you said that Miranda co-wrote this, so I don't know who originally wrote it, if it was her and someone else joined her. It's usually the other way around with artists like Miranda. Somebody writes it and then Miranda adds her flair to it. But I wonder if this is partly Miranda's self-revelation of her life on the road, you know, in the past anyway. I don't know.
Another
Nashville.
Standing at the sink, not looking in the mirror.
Yeah, man.
Don't know where I am or how I got here.
Self-loathing.
Well, the only thing that I know how to find is another vibe.
All about habits.
Another vice.
This reminded me another song of hers. I don't think it was Old Shit. It was something, another one. But yeah, I mean, this song, I mean, obviously it was in Nashville, more Nashville than, you know, Eastern Kentucky or somewhere. But I love Miranda's stuff. I mean, there's something about her voice, her presentation. This is more Nashville. I did wear the right hat for this. A lot of Miranda stuff reminds me in a sense of like Alan Jackson's stuff, where they have this ability to appeal to both crowds, you know, more pop country people as well as traditionalists. And Miranda's just amazing. And life is about habits. That's what the song is. And then when you're in the spiral of repeat bad behavior and you know it's bad and you keep doing it, those habits, you have to find a way to stop. And usually, sometimes you have to hit rock bottom before you make that decision or summon up something in you to stop those habits. And Aristotle said, basically, without going into the details of that, but just that life, you know, logic can lead you in ways to better habits in life. And then once things are habitualized, you no longer have to think about them. They just become you. And that's good or bad. You know, in this case, Miranda's, you know, the whoever she was representing in this, conscience was speaking to her that I don't want to be this person. Maybe I'm addicted to goodbyes. You know, that's why I'm getting in someone else's bed and leaving in the morning. Whatever makes us loathe ourselves and why we do these things to get through this life, you know, so much I don't judge, but not being able to look in the mirror, you know, that's a rough one. And all that. So better habits are the cure for that. Easier said than done, but it's doable. So, oh, geez, Betty, what do I rate this? I like the message. I like the honesty. Just, goodness, if this is a self story, it is for a lot of people, but I don't know if Miranda's copping to that or not in this song. But nonetheless, I admire the honesty to sing a song like this, even if it's not about her life. But I am going to come in with an 8.4. I've got some, Love Your Memory is my one, maybe my top Miranda song. I think that's in a 10. I think I gave that one a 10. Miranda's got songs that are just off the charts, but this was a good one. So it's, I just can't turn Miranda off when I'm listening to her. That's how I know I love an artist. There's always something I'm looking for, and there's always something I find, whether it was what I was looking for in the next moment or minute or song. It's always there with Miranda. Somewhere in there, there's always another moment where I'm taken to a different place, and I love that. So, Betty Stafford, thank you for that. There you go. All right, guys, have a great day. See you on another video. I'll keep rocking the country.